To add on to what we said yesterday, and also clarify to make sure it's clear, we said the halacha makes a distinction between when you light candles for Shabbat, where there's a machloket, a lot of people hold that you're allowed to make a tenai condition that the candles should not be binding as your acceptance of Shabbat. That's what we've talked about in the past, that even though a man certainly lights the candles, he's still certainly allowed to engage in melacha, and of course also pray the regular weekday mincha. However, there's a difference when it comes to praying Kabbalat Shabbat. When a person already accepts Shabbat through tefillah, since he mentions the Kiddushat Shabbat, then he cannot go back afterwards and pray Tefillat Mincha. And again, this is very relevant at this time of year when people pray oftentimes Shabbat very early. So therefore, if a person answered already Baruch Hu, that's the main thing. If a person answers Baruch Hu, he comes to Beit Knesset, he answers Baruch Hu, he's not allowed after, that is for him binding, Shabbat has been accepted, and he cannot pray Mincha afterwards. Okay? If the Tzibur has already prayed, he comes in, there's like two Minyanim in the Beit Knesset, and one is an early Minyan, they already accepted the Shabbat, then he is not supposed to even pray Mincha in that Beit Knesset. Again, he can go to a different room, he doesn't have to leave the building. He can go to a different room, upstairs, downstairs, side room, but he cannot pray in the Beit Knesset. Why? Because since they've already said Baruch Hu, they've already accepted Shabbat, that's a real acceptance of Shabbat, it's not right for him to go now and make it into a weekday by praying the weekday Mincha. That's very important. A person comes late on a Friday night, like here in the summer, make sure that you don't pray Mincha in the same room as everybody else who already accepted Shabbat. How about the other way? Let's say a person already accepted, he was part of the early Minyan, and now the second Minyan is coming in, and he's sticking around, he wants to maybe read the Torah a little bit, Shnayim Mikra Vechad Targum, and now they're going to say the Kiddushah of Amidah. In the Chazara, they're going to say the Mincha with Kiddushah. Is he allowed to answer? The halacha is that even though he already accepted Shabbat by praying Arvit, he's still allowed to answer the Kiddushah of the weekday Mincha that he's going to overhear. So those are the halachot, a little bit of when a person sort of has this mix between people who have accepted and not accepted Shabbat through tefillah at the same time.